Dear students, today we are going to discuss about a topic from Foundations of Nursing, that is Florence Nightingale Environmental Theory. So in this lesson, we are going to see about brief introduction about theorist, major concepts, sub-concepts, types of environment, and the theory and relevance in nursing and nursing process. About the theorist. So you already know about the theorist. This is just a review for you all. Florence Nightingale. Born on May 12, 1820 to William and Frances Nightingale, felt strong calling by God to help the sick, and she attended nursing school at Germany in 1851. In 1853, Florence accepted her first position as nursing superintendent. And she was asked to nurse British soldiers during Crimean War in 1854. And it was a turning point in her career. She worked tirelessly, caring for the ill and wounded with the other 31 female nurses she had recruited and became known as the Lady with the Lamp. She returned to England in 1856. Now we are going to see what are the contributions of Florence Nightingale. Have you heard about polar area? Or do you have any idea about this polar area? We can see a pictorial of this polar area. This is a diagram dated 1858 by Florence Nightingale of a colored pie chart to illustrate the reason of mortality of death in the British Army. And she used mathematics and statistics to create polar area diagram. Coming to the notes on nursing. Florence Nightingale wrote the Notes on Nursing based on her environmental model in 1859. Students, you have to write it and learn, because this environmental model that is based on her Notes on Nursing. What it is and what it is not, based on her observations and experiences while treating the soldiers during the war. And major contributions of Nightingale as a nurse, researcher, statistician, social reformer, educator, and theorist. She is the first nursing theorist. And Florence Nightingale is the mother of modern nursing. And we are going to the theory. Nightingale's environmental theory. So first of all, we'll see about the definition of nursing. The environmental theory by Florence Nightingale defined nursing as the act of utilizing the environment of the patient to assist him in his recovery. So here we are modifying the environment of the patient. And Nightingale discussed the environmental theory in her book, Notes on Nursing, what it is and what it is not. So we are going to see the major concepts of Florence Nightingale theory. So major concepts based on nursing, human beings, environment and health. So what is her concept about nursing? What nursing has to do is to put the patient in the best condition for nature to act upon him. And what about human beings? Human beings are not defined by Nightingale specifically. Human beings are defined in relation to their environment and the impact of the environment upon them. So here we can see like how much stress Florence Nightingale has given on human beings and nursing based on environment. The environment, the physical environment is stressed by Nightingale in her writing. In her theory, Nightingale's writing reflects a community health model in which all that surrounds human beings is considered in relation to their state of health. About health. Nightingale did not define health specifically. She stated, "We know nothing of health. The positive of which pathology is negative, except for the observation and experience." So she stressed on the observation and experience. So we are going to see about the sub-concepts of environmental theory. 10 major concepts of the environmental theory. This is also identified as Nightingale's canons. First is ventilation and warming. Second, light and noise. Third, cleanliness of the area. Fourth, health of houses. Fifth, bed and bedding. Fifth, personal cleanliness. Sixth, variety. Seventh, variety. Eighth, offering hope and advice. Ninth, food. And last, 10th one is social considerations. We will see one by one. First is ventilation and warming. So what Florence Nightingale was explaining is that nurses was to keep the air he breathes as pure as the external air without chilling. Nightingale was very concerned about noxious air and effluvia, that is foul odors that came from environment. Apart from this, Nightingale stressed the importance of room temperature. The patient should not be too warm or too cold. Here, Nightingale stressed about the fresh air and room temperature. Second is about light. She viewed that direct sunlight was what patients wanted, although acknowledging a lack of scientific rationale for it. She noted that light has quite real and tangible effects upon the human body. Next is about noise, the importance of noise, like how we have to maintain. She stated that patients should never be waked intentionally or accidentally during the first part of sleep. She asserted that whispered or long conversations about patients are thoughtless and cruel. Nurses' responsibility is to assess and stop different kinds of noise for the well-being of patient. Next is about health of houses. The importance of the health of houses as being closely related to the presence of pure air, pure water, efficient drainage, cleanliness, and light. Next is about the cleanliness of the area. Cleanliness outside the house affects the health of the person inside. Next is about bed and bedding. Why a nurse has to change the bed sheets regularly and how we have to maintain the cleanliness of bedding. The Nightingale noted that an adult in health exhales about 3 pints of moisture through the lungs and skin in a 24-hour period. This organic matter enters the sheets and stays there unless the bedding is changed and aired frequently. She believed that the bed should be placed in the lightest part of the room and placed so the patient could see out of a window. She also reminded the caregiver never to lean against, sit upon, or unnecessarily shake the bed of the patient. That is why we also insist while we go to wards and all, we are not supposed to sit upon or unnecessarily shake the bed or never to lean against the bed. Personal cleanliness. The need for cleanliness is extended to the patient, the nurse, and the environment. Nightingale viewed the functions of the skin is important, believing that many disorders are caused breaks in the skin. Next is about the variety. Variety in the sense of changes in color and form and like patient surroundings. She discussed the needs for changes in color and form, including bringing the patient brightly colored flowers or plants. She also advocated rotating 10 or 12 paintings and engravings each day, week, or month to provide variety for the patient. So all these things create some sense of well-being to the patient. Nightingale also advocated reading, needlework, writing, and cleaning as activities to relieve the sick of the bedroom boredom. Next is about nutrition and taking food. Nightingale noted that individuals desire Different foods at different times of the day, and that frequent small servings may be more beneficial to the patient than a large breakfast or dinner. She urged that no business be done with patients while they are eating, because this was distraction. So how we are maintaining the privacy of the patient. Chattering hopes and advices. This is about giving false hopes and advices to the patient. False hope was depressing to the patients and caused them to worry and become fatigued later. She believed that sick persons should hear good news that would assist them to become healthier. Next is about social considerations. Nightingale supported the importance of looking beyond the persons to the social environment in which he or she lived. She observed that generations of families lived and died in poverty. So, we have seen about the Nightingale's canon, that is ventilation and warming, light and noise, cleanliness of the area, health of houses, bed and bedding, personal cleanliness, variety, offering hope and advice for, and finally social considerations. So we are going to the types of environment. Nightingale mainly stressed about physical environment, psychological environment, and social environment. And these three environments are mutually related. So physical environment, we have seen the major components that coming under physical environment. Psychological environment, especially communication with the patient and advices. Social environment. So all these factors, environmental factors, we are regulating in order to reduce the mortality data and prevention of diseases. Next, we are going to see the relevance of this environmental theory in nursing practice, education, and research. How in nursing practice? First of all, for disease control. Sanitation. Next is sanitation or water treatment. Third is sick building syndrome. Fourth is about waste disposal. Fifth, control of room temperature. Sixth is noise management. Now, how in education? That is principles of nursing training and skills measurement through licensing by the use of testing methods and research, use of graphical representation like the bar or bike diagrams, notes on nursing. And now we are going to see how we can apply this Nightingale. And next we are going to the implementation phase. After assessing all these factors, especially environmental factors, we are implementing this model. Provide adequate ventilation by opening doors and windows. Keep the surrounding environment clean, linen, bed, utensils. Keep the patient in warm and comfortable room. Avoid unnecessary noise. Increase stimulus through a greater exposure to sunlight and fresh air. Provide nutritious diet and encourage for liquid diet frequently, proper disposal of sputum, human excreta, proper dress up, maintenance, maintaining room temperature and wear warm clothes, isolate the patient from the children from the other patient, keep in stimulating environment, provide sufficient advice, information about disease, prognosis, course of treatment to the patient and family members. So after implementation, we are evaluating the patient based on observation on the effect of a changing environment on the health of a person, specially focus on the vital signs and adequate knowledge about disease condition. So this is about the Nightingale's environmental theory. So today we have seen about the theorist, major concepts of this theory, sub-concepts, types of environment, relevance in nursing and nursing process. Thank you for listening. Or insufficient knowledge regarding diseases.